Hey there guys, my name is Ryan. This is the first video I've ever done, and basically I'm just capturing, well, kind of thought I'd undertake a little project. Basically I'm going to try and design on Solidworks, create a BBS RA alloy wheel. It's actually part of my university project I've been handed. I'm a first year aerospace student and our first year is common, so it's just general engineering. We've been given an assignment to design, using CAD, a double wishbone suspension system, and that's all. But I thought I'd, you know, kind of go the extra mile, and being as I based mine around the Polo G40, which is an old VW, a supercharged 1.3 VW, which is a car you really do, what I think is fantastic. I thought I'd kind of go the extra mile and create the alloys, the chassis, put it all together and see how it turns out. So here we go. I don't actually have any proper dimensions for this alloy. All I do have is I have the width, which is 5.5J, and the diameter, and it's a 13-inch wheel, and that's all I have. So basically what I've tried to do is I've tried to find pictures on the internet, try to find as large pictures as I can, as many angles as I can, and basically try to approximate each length of every single feature and various angles and everything else. I don't know how it's going to turn out. I suspect rather badly, because approximating on a CAD program from a picture simply doesn't work. But in the case that it does work, I thought I'd record it just so one of you guys can have a go, and hopefully, well, the dream case scenario is improve on it and maybe help me out in return, and I'll end up with a better project, so everyone wins. I'm using freeware screen capture. It's it's Cam Studio, and sadly the audio lags quite far behind the video, so I'm afraid I can't talk you through any of the dimensions I'm doing, just because simply by the time you heard it the dimensions would be completely irrelevant and you wouldn't have a clue what I was talking about. So that's why I'm using the smart dimension tool, just because it brings up the dimensions nice and large, just so it's, well, hopefully easier for anyone watching this, if they want to have a go, to follow it. Yeah, I'm by no means an expert on Solidworks or CAD at all. I started using it at college last year, just for kind of small design projects, nothing major, and it's pretty much self-taught myself. Well, basically what I know, hence why my method isn't very good. I suspect if any of you are really accomplished on the program, you'll be able to, you know, follow my method or point out things that I'm doing which I could be done a lot easier. You know, if you do have any such constructive criticism or advice, please do tell me, because obviously it may make my life a lot easier in the future. Oh, by the way, I've just noticed it's going to look rather strange, the fact that I'm typing in such precise numbers. There is a kind of reason for that. I've done a rough sketch in front of me where I've approximated everything. And I don't know why I did it. For some reason, I approximated everything in inches, because that's where my original values were given in. And then I had to convert my values for inches over, and it just ended up with, I just ended up with very precise numbers, which is rather strange considering what a bodge this drawing is going to be. But no, hopefully it'll turn out okay. My drawing looks, well, it looks in proportion, so hopefully it'll be okay.